B.N. Panikkar, a people's leader who is well known as the father of library and literacy movement in Kerala. Born on 1st March 1909, he started the Sanadhana Dharma Vayanashala in his hometown, Nilampirur, Alappuzha. Vayichu Valaruka, Read and Grow is the slogan preached and practiced by P.N. Panikkar. Panikkar led the formation of Travancore Library Association in 1945 with 47 rural libraries. He succeeded in bringing 6,000 libraries under the Kerala Granthashala Sangam. This is one of the largest public library network in the world. Government of serving 19th June as the Vayana Dinam Reading Day and 19th to 25th June as Vayana Varam Reading Week. The P.N. Panikkar Foundation is an offshoot initiative of CADAS and was formed in remembrance of P.N. Panikkar under the chairmanship of Justice V.R. Krishnaiyar. In furtherance of his mission, the foundation has developed programs like school reading clubs, total digital literacy, skill development, employability enhancement program, effective science communication, rural entrepreneurship development, organic farming, promotion of green jobs, etc. On 4th January 2014, the foundation launched the massive popular initiative of achieving 10% digital literacy in Kerala. Dr. Manmohan Singh, the then Prime Minister of India, inaugurated the scheme at Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. As of 31st March 2016, the foundation has made more than 3.25 lakh citizens digitally literate spread across 53 panchayats of Kerala. As a second stage of this initiative, P.N. Panikkar Foundation is going to commence a program on digital libraries in the state.
Kerala can be rightly described as the land of public libraries.
Public libraries are the only public institution that offers free and unbiased access to knowledge resources.
എൻ്റെ കുട്ടിക്കാലം മുതലേ എനിക്ക് ഈ ഗ്രന്ഥശാലയായിട്ട് ബന്ധമുണ്ട്.
ഞാൻ 2 വർഷത്തോളമായി ലൈബ്രറിയിൽ വരാറുണ്ട്.
ഈ ലൈബ്രറി 1940 അതായത് 1940 സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ചെയ്തത്.
ഈ ഗ്രന്ഥശാലയിലുള്ള അപൂർവങ്ങൾ ശേഖരങ്ങൾ അടങ്ങുന്ന മുറിയാണിത്. അതിൽ ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഒന്ന് നമ്മുടെ ഹോർത്തൂസ് ഇൻഡിക്കൂസ് മലബാർ കിസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന മഹത് ഗ്രന്ഥമാണ്.
മുമ്പ് ഈ ഗ്രന്ഥശാലയിലെ ബുക്കുകൾ എടുക്കാൻ ചുറ്റുപാടുള്ള ആൾക്കാരും ഒത്തിരി ആൾക്കാരുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ഇന്ന് ഈ സമൂഹത്തിൽ വായനാശീലം വളരെ കുറവായിരിക്കുകയാണ്.
ഇന്നത്തെ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ യുഗത്തിന്റെ ഒരു രീതിയും വരുമ്പോൾ നമുക്ക് ഇവിടെ ഒരുപാട് വായനക്കാരുടെ എണ്ണം കുറവായിട്ടാണ് വരുന്നത്.
എല്ലാ പേരും വായിക്കുന്നവരുണ്ട്. പത്രമായിരുന്നാലും ലേഖനങ്ങളായിരുന്നാലും എല്ലാവരും വായിക്കുന്നുണ്ടാവും. പക്ഷേ ഇതെല്ലാം ഫേസ്ബുക്കിൽ കൂടെ ആയി പോകുന്നു. മൊബൈൽ ഫോണുകളാണ് ഇന്ന് ആ സ്ഥാനം കയ്യേറിയിരിക്കുന്നത്.
പീപ്പിൾ ആർ മോർ ആഫ്റ്റർ പെർപ്പസ്ഫുൾ റീഡിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ഹിയർ ദി ഇന്റർനെറ്റ് ഹാസ് കം ഇൻ എ ബിഗ് വേ.
അവർ പബ്ലിക് ലൈബ്രറീസ് നീഡ് ടു ട്രാൻസ്ഫോം ടു മീറ്റ് ദി ചേഞ്ചിങ് റിക്വയർമെന്റ്സ് ഓഫ് അവർ സിറ്റിസൺസ്
വിത്ത് ദി റിസൾട്ട് ദാറ്റ് ദി യങ്ങർ generation is more fond of e-reading rather than the conventional book reading. They have to give facilities for e-reading and they have to build up e-resources in their collection.
The relevance of India public.
Okay, so that's a quick video of the Panikkar Foundation's initiative. So I will just play the video of National Digital Library of India for your
भारत देश सन 1940 को ब्रिटिश हुकूमत के चंगुल से आजाद हुआ. देश आजादी के बाद एक लोकतंत्र की स्थापना हुई थी. आज समय आ गया है कि हम शिक्षा को भी डेमोक्रेटाइज करें.
द नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया इज ट्रूली बिल्ट ऑफ द पीपल बाय द पीपल एंड फॉर द पीपल. It is our knowledge legacy to future generations.
ఈ ఉద్యమాన్ని దేశ నలుమూలలా వ్యాపింపజేసి ప్రజలకు మంచి నాణ్యమైన చదువు అందించాలనే ఉద్దేశంతో నేషనల్ డిజిటల్ లైబ్రరీ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా ఏర్పడింది.
छोटे बच्चे हैं जो पूरी प्रिविलेज नहीं ले पाते थे बुक्स दी या जर्नल्स दी कुछ अच्छा मटेरियल जिस तो वो वांझे रह जाते थे उन्हें बहुत अच्छे तरीके नाल मिल सकता है.
इंटरनेट और हायत मोबाइल टेक्नोलॉजी और कंप्यूटर यूज करी ভাৰতৰ সকলো শিক্ষাৰ্থীয়ে সকলো ঠাইৰ পৰা নেশ্যনেল ডিজিটেল লাইব্ৰেৰী অফ ইণ্ডিয়া
শিক্ষণ পদ্ধতি আছে, ব্যৱহাৰিক জ্ঞান আছে, থিচিছ আছে, டிசர்டேஷன்ஸ் சே
நாங்கள் இந்த தேசிய லைசன்ஸ் பயன்படுத்துவதனால இந்த நூலகத்தின் உள்ளடக்கத்தை எல்லோரும் இலவசமாக நாடு தழுவி பயன்படுத்தலாம்
আমাদের ন্যাশনাল ডিজিটাল লাইব্রেরি এমন একটা প্ল্যাটফর্ম যা আমাদের সভ্যতা সংস্কৃতি এবং শিক্ষার সম্পদকে বাঁচিয়ে রাখতে সাহায্য করে
The true success of our library lies with its users. Hence, I invite all of India to make use of this platform.
I am National Digital Library of India.
I am in National Digital Library of India.
I am the National Digital Library of India.
I am National Digital Library of India.
My National Digital Library of India.
Nenu National Digital Library of India.
Hoochu National Digital Library of India.
Naan India vin. தேசிய நூலகம்
மீ நிருபமா பவுடேகர் நேஷனல் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி ஆஃப் இந்தியா அஹெல்
ஐ அம் நேஷனல் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி ஆஃப் இந்தியா
மே நேஷனல் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி ஆஃப் இந்தியா
ஆமீ நேஷனல் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி
வி ஆர் நேஷனல் டிஜிட்டல் லைப்ரரி ஆஃப் இந்தியா
எவரிவன் நவ இட்ஸ் 5:57 வி வில் வெயிட் ஃபார் 3 மோர் மினிட்ஸ் பிஃபோர் வி பிகின் தி செஷன் So now let's look at why NDLI. In the last few years, there has been a drastic reduction in the financial and human resources for libraries. So what does that imply? It means when there is a less reduction in the budget and the human resources, it means the access to quality knowledge resources are going to be reduced. Then which in turn will have give less knowledge and resources to the faculty members and the students, which in turn will result in the lesser number of learning outcomes as well. So this is a interlinked process. So the moment you reduce the library's budget and human resources, it's going to directly impact on the learning outcome. So that is, in the last few years, we have seen that budget has been drastically reduced. And then the second one is, in many of the libraries, wherever we have visited, there is a additional requirement of physical infrastructure for stacking of resources. In many of the places wherever we have seen resources are unpacked, they were lying in the same cotton boxes or in the same tied ropes without even being unopened because they don't have space to stack these new resources. So that's another so in the physical libraries you need more physical infrastructure to stack resources because these libraries might have been set up like few years back with some vision in mind but as we grow there is a requirement for more physical infrastructure and also we have come across this challenge of say for example when there is a good resource say for example when there is a good book published by an international author or an international publisher see hundreds of students and faculty members might want to access it at the same time, right? And in most of the situation, the library may have couple of same copies of the same book. So what happens is like either the students have to go to the faculty member, the student get it photocopied and then return back to them, or they take the reference material, they take notes. These are the two options. So accessing the same resources by multiple persons at the same also a challenge in the physical libraries. Apart from this, we have also come across situations or challenges like books being missing or the articles being or the journals being missing or the thesis being missed or hidden or damaged. So these are the things we have seen it in the physical libraries. So keeping all these in mind, actually wanted to democratize the situation. So it means they actually wanted to take forward the quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizen, whether it's they're coming from an IITs, IIMs, or from a small rural institution. So they wanted to give quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizens. So they actually wanted to, by way of doing this, they wanted to democratize the education. So the government of India launched National Digital Library of India as a knowledge, national knowledge asset on 19 June 2018. So that during the remembrance day of 23rd annual remembrance day of Shri P.N. Panika and the then Prime Minister Shri Prakash Javadekar ji launched this India Lake portal to the nation. Now we will look at what do we have at India Lake. At India Lake, we primarily store metadata. So some of you may know metadata in technical terms or in definition terms, it means data about data. But in this context, metadata is nothing but basic information about a resource. Say, for example, if there is a book, the name of the title of the book, who is the author, who is the publisher, how many number of pages, what is the abstract it is covering. So that is at NDLI, we primarily store metadata. We don't store any full text resources. Okay. So then you may ask, how do we give access to the full text resources at NDLI? So kindly have a look at this diagram. So imagine this NDLI repository. This is, imagine this as the NDLI portal. Okay. How we function is, say for example, if say Delhi University, for example, Delhi University has 1,000 non-copyrighted digital open source digital resources, okay, which they want to share it with every Indian citizen. So then what we do is we first help them in setting up an institutional digital repository, which we call it as IDRs. So we follow DSpace and we help them in setting up an IDR, and also we follow a metadata schema. So our metadata schema is available on our project website, so you can have a look at it. So our metadata schema, and then once the IDR and the metadata schema is given, they just have to enter these details. And what our portal does is, so once the IDR and the metadata is ready, we just pull the metadata from this IDR and harvest it in our NDLI portal. So once it is harvested, say for example, if a researcher from Kannur wants to access this resource published by Delhi University, so he comes to NDLI, he searches for the resource. Suppose if it's available at Delhi University, what we do is once he clicks on that resource, we redirect him to Delhi University's IDR. Delhi University's IDR verifies this is an is he an authentic person. If he or she is an authentic person, then it gives the entire full text resources. Suppose if it's an open and full text resource, then the entire full text resource is directly given to the researcher. So we only store the metadata for search and browse, whereas the full text is directly given from the partner institution to the content user, registered user of NDLI. So as I mentioned, we are not a content creating agency, or we don't digitize content. We primarily partner with various educational research and publishing partners. Okay, so far we have partnered with 293 content contributors. So you can see some of the logos, familiar logos of India as well as international people who are partners of National Digital Library of India. Now you may ask me what type of content we have at NDLI. So computer science, information and general works, we have closer to 1 crore resources. Philosophy and psychology, we have 5.4 lakh resources. Religion, 2 lakh resources. Social sciences, 45 lakh resources. Language, 1 lakh resources. Natural sciences and mathematics, 84 lakh resources. Technology, 1 crore resources. Arts, fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakh resources. Literature and rhetoric, 7.8 lakh resources. History and geography, 6.1 lakh resources. So if you add these entire resources, we have closer to 4.86 crore resources as of today. Then let's look at what type of content we have. So you name any form of educational and research material, we have it at NDLI, be it a faculty publication, be it a thesis or a dissertation, be it a research project, a lecture slide, video, class notes, courseware, term papers, assignments, assessments, solutions, lab experiments, case studies, question banks, periodicals, e-books, journals, annual reports, project reports, working papers, data sets, benchmarks, models, manuscripts. So you name any major form of educational and knowledge resources, they are available at NDLI. On what type of resource type we have? Article is the major type of resource. We have 2.9 crore resources as articles. followed by books, which are 64 lakh resources. Now, let's access options. So, at NDA, we have five different types of access options. First access option is open, which is denoted by a green lag with open, and then followed by NDL users, wherein you can see a person with the NDL written on his chest, and then limited access. You can see a black color of open symbol, and then subscribed resources, and then restricted resources. So subscribed resources, so open and NDL user, these two access options gives you full text resources, which means you can actually download the entire book or an article or a video book or a PowerPoint slide, the entire resources, download it for and use it for educational purposes without having to pay a single penny. Okay. Whereas limited access resources, say for example, if it's a 30 page article, maybe out of which 10 or 15 page may be visible, the remaining pages may not be visible. So this is called limited access. And the fourth access option subscribed is, suppose if you're institution is subscribed to IEEE or Springer, then you may be able to access these resources. Suppose if your institution is not subscribed, then you may not be able to download these resources. And the fifth access option is restricted. These resources may not be available, openly available for outside of institution. So these are the five different types of access options. So now let's look at access-wise options, access option-wise content. So open resources are 2.75 crore resources, and the NDL resources are 77 lakh resources. So if you add these two, closer to 3.5 crore resources, that is 75% of our resources are full text resources. So you can use these 75% of our resources are free of cost, and you can use it for educational and research purposes. So the content we have is meant for every age group, starting from the school-going students to college-going youths, working professionals, academicians, researchers, entrepreneurs, and lifelong learners. So we have resources for every age group. Now I will show you how to access NDLI. If you have time, you can also try doing it maybe using your mobile phone or your desktop. So for accessing NDLI, what you need to do is first go to a search engine, be it Google or Yahoo, whatever you feel comfortable. Go to the search engine and search for National Digital Library of India. Okay, and the first URL you get, which is ndl.iitkgp.ac.in or ndl.gov.in, both the URLs work. So you check, you just have to click on the URL. Okay. Once you click on this URL, it will take you to our homepage. So this is how our homepage looks like. So on the top, you can see this language. Suppose if you want to change the language interface into your own mother tongue. So currently this language interface is available in 11 languages, including English. So you can see the various language from here. And on the left, you have a browse option, search option. Also at the center, we have the search box. Okay. Suppose if you want to search on a topic, say I've searched for a topic called Malayalam, I typed for a topic called Malayalam literature, and then you just have to click on search. And also on the home page, you can see three new tabs. So yes, functionality was not there. We have just recently introduced. So there is a tab called Study at Home. There is a tab called COVID-19 Research Repository. And there is another tab called Featured Collections. I will talk about this tabs in a short while. So now let's see how to do a search in NDLI. So I searched for a topic called Malayalam literature. Okay. And here I have changed the language interface into Malayalam. So suppose if you want to do it in Tamil or in Hindi or in Bangla, Gujarati, Marathi, Kannada, Uriya, Telugu, you can all do it. So we have it, and currently it's available in 11 Indian languages, and soon it will be available in almost all the 22 official languages of India. So Malayalam literature, and then I applied a filter called language Malayalam. I wanted on the resources of on the topic of Malayalam literature in Malayalam. Okay. Similarly, suppose if you search for a topic called Hindi literature and then you wanted it in Hindi literature, go to this tab, Hindi language tab, and then choose Hindi, then you will get only the resources in Hindi language. So just give me a moment. I will just reconnect my audio. Is my audio clear now? If yes, kindly put it in the chat window. If it's still a problem, just let me know. Okay, so I will go ahead. Thank you. So now the second topic I searched was on history of English literature. So I typed history of English literature and then I applied a filter called subject category. So here I applied two subjects. I chose two subjects, language and literature. 674,000 results on this topic of history of English literature. So before I move ahead, I wanted to tell you there are two things that you need to remember in using NDLI. First is the search keyword. You should be very particular about choosing the right keyword, search keyword. And the second option you need to remember is applying the various filter option, or at least knowing the various filter options to narrow down the results. So I will just read out the various filter options that are available. On the left hand side, this is I'm showing you the desktop applications. So soon I will show you the mobile app, how to use the mobile app as well. So there is a filter called access restriction. The second filter is called author. Third filter is called subject category. Fourth filter is called educational degree. Fifth filter is called difficulty level. Sixth filter is called educational level. Seventh filter is called file format. Eighth filter is called language. Ninth filter is called learning resource type. Tenth filter is called source. So these are the 10 filter options that are available on the left hand side. And there is an on the right hand side, we have a filter called content type. So in the desktop application, we have 11 filter options. Okay. Now I will move on to the next slide. So next topic was instruction techniques. So here I wanted only video lectures on this topic and also relevant to an educational level of undergraduate and postgraduate. So what I did was I went to educational level filter and then I chose UG and PG. And then on the right hand side, I wanted only video. So I clicked on video. So I got how many results? I got 1,066 results on this topic of construction techniques. And the next topic I searched was on engineering mechanics. So here I wanted only from an author called Sudarshan Iyengar. So I went to author filter and then I chose Sudarshan Iyengar. I got 862 results on this topic of engineering mechanics from Sudarshan Iyengar. And the next topic I searched was on artificial intelligence. So now you can see I have picked three filters. This subject category, I chose computer science and in technology. And then access restriction, I want only for open resources. And there I applied was on source. So I wanted it from only MIT open courseware. I got 64 results on this topic of artificial intelligence. And the next topic I searched was on Java programming. So I applied the two filters, subject category filters, computer science and technology. And then I wanted only video. So I got 3,100. Okay, so just give me a moment. Let me just change over the network. It may be a network problem also. Just give me a moment. Is my audio better now? I've switched over to a new network and reconnected my audio. Is my audio better? Okay, so thank you. And the next topic I searched was on financial accounting. So I wanted only video lectures available on this topic of financial accounting. So I went to the content type filter and I chose only video. I got 1727 results on this topic of financial accounting. And the next topic I searched was on sociology. Again, I wanted only video lectures on this topic of sociology. I got 455 results. Then I searched for a topic called biochemistry and I wanted to know various theses available on this topic. So what I did was, so there is a filter called source. So I wanted to see only the thesis. So what I did was I went to InfibNet, source, InfibNet, Shodganga. Shodganga is the repository of all the Indian thesis, electronic thesis. And Shodgangotri is the all the electronic dissertation. So here I wanted only thesis. So I went to source. I chose InfibNet Shodganga. I got 3,383 resource on this topic of biochemistry. Okay. Similarly, if you want to know the various theses available on a given topic, then what you can do is search for the topic and go to source and choose InfibNet Shodganga. Then you will be able to see what are the various theses available on the given topic. And the next topic I searched was on algebra and calculus. So I wanted the video lectures only from Khan Academy. So I went to source, I chose Khan Academy. I got 10,208 results on this topic of algebra and calculus. So as I mentioned earlier, so during this time of lockdown due to COVID-19 pandemic, our team has actually classified all the resources, the 4.8 crore resources into various educational categories. So here you can see this study at home section. So we have resources for school students and also we have CBSE examination preparatory, especially for 10th and 12th students. We have content for engineering students. We have science content, humanities, literature, management and law. Suppose if you want to access contents which are relevant for school, you just have to go and click for school. Suppose if you want content only for engineering, just have to click on engineering, then you will be able to see the content which are relevant. So I will show you how the content looks like. So before we go, so there is also a research repository on this topic of COVID-19. So you can see the scholarly publications on this topic of COVID-19, various data sets, documents and videos, journals and conferences, ideas and funding. So you can see the various research repository on this topic of COVID-19. And also we have a team keeps on featuring various resources. So you can see the various percentage of Chatterjit Ray on this day, what happened in the history, person of the week, topic of the week. So these are all our new initiatives. Suppose if I want to open this school content, so just have to click on school, then you will be able to see the content available for school students. Video lectures for school students, JEE preparation materials, simulations, activities, self-assessment and various study materials, books from CBSE, NCERT and other state boards, books for general reading. Okay. Suppose if you click on engineering, it will take you to this page. You can see the common subjects, aerospace engineering, architecture, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science and engineering, electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mechanical engineering, mining engineering. Suppose if you want to see the contents available computer science engineering, just go here and click, then you will be able to see the other resources relevant for this subject category. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to download a resource from NDLA. So I searched for a topic called research methodology and I wanted it from a source called Lovely Professional University. I got 1438 results. Suppose if you want to open or download this resource, then what you need to do is just click on this resource. Once you click, it will open this page. So this is called metadata. So on the top, you can see two tabs. One is content and the one is metadata. First, click on the metadata. Once you click, this information will display. So this is called metadata. As I mentioned earlier, this is the basic information about this resource. So the title is research methodology, sources, Lovely Professional University, content type is text, Publisher is Excel Books Private Limited. File format is PDF. Language is English. And suppose if you see this information is useful, then the second thing you need to notice is access restriction. So since it's an open icon, it means you can download the full text resources. Okay. And the third thing you need to notice is whether you have logged in or not. So here you can see my name, which means I can actually download and download this entire resources at free of cost. So suppose if you want to download, then what you need to do is just go here and click on content. Once you click on content, the entire 338 pages of content gets downloaded into your desktop or laptop or mobile phone, depending on the device you use. Imagine, suppose if you have not logged into the system. So here you can see you have not logged in. It's not showing my name. So in that case, what you need to do is, so there is it is asking you to please log in to view this content. So you just have to click on this login. Once you click on this login, this pop-up window will appear. Okay. Suppose if you are already registered in DLI and you remember your registered email ID and password, just enter your registered email ID and password and enter the CAPTCHA and click login. Then the content will automatically get downloaded. Okay. Simple. Imagine you registered at NTLA couple of months back or couple of years back and you forgot your username and password, or you forgot your password but you remember the registered email ID. In that case, what you can do is just click on this account recovery, then this pop-up window will appear. Okay, so it will ask you to enter your registered email ID and then you submit. Once you submit, then you will get a password reset URL. Okay. Once you get, you will get a your password and come back and enter your email ID and password and login. Suppose if you heard about DLA but you have never registered at DLA, then in that case, what you have to do is click on register. So once you click on register, this registration form will open. And see this form, it will ask for your full name, your email ID, password, confirm password, date of birth, gender, city, just basic information about you. Four details are mandatory: your full name, email ID, password, and confirm password. Once you enter these four details, then you can, the rest of the fields are optional only. You can fill it or you can fill it later also. Once you click on sign up, you will get a verification email. Just click on the verification URL, then your account will get activated. So this is the registration will not take more than 5 minutes and it's a one-time registration. Access to how much 3.5 crore resources at free of cost. Suppose if it's a video lecture, this is how the video lecture will look like. Okay. So I earlier told you, for using NDLA, you need to remember two things. One is the site with proper spelling. And the second important thing is the various filter options. Okay. Here I'm going to talk about some 8 important filter options that are available here. The first filter option I'm going to talk about is access restriction. Okay. Suppose if you want only full text resources, then what you need to do is click on open and NDLA. If you click on open, then you will get only the full text resources. And the second filter option is author. Suppose you searched a topic and this author, suppose if you want this resources from this author, Wei Zhang, just click here the Wei Zhang, then you will be able to get the resources from Wei Zhang itself. And the third filter option is subject category. So this is classified as per the DDC's duodecimal classification format. So you can, depending on the topic, you need to choose the subject category. Okay. And the fourth filter option is file format. Suppose you want only PDF files or MP3 files, just click PDF and MP3. Suppose if you want only MP4 files, just choose MP4 files. So based depending on the file format requirement, you can choose the content. And the filter option language. So at NDLA, we have content in more than 300 Indian as well as international languages. So you can choose, you can search for, suppose if you want content only in Hindi, just go here and search for Hindi, then just choose and you will get content only in Hindi. The sixth filter option is learning resource type. At NDLA, we have more than 60 different types of learning resource types. Suppose if we want audiobook or newspaper articles or studies, we can do learning resource type. Seventh filter option is source. So earlier, there are 293 content partners available. So from the source tab, you can see the 293 content partners and choose relevant content partners from whom you want the content. And the filter option, which is available only in the desktop, if you want video lectures, just choose video lectures. So I already mentioned to you about the various Indian language interface. In Angla, Gujarati, Kannada, Marathi, Oriya, Tamil, Assamese. I think Punjabi is also on the way. So you have to just go to the, on the top, you will see the language interface. Just choose and then choose the language you will be able to change the entire interface to your mother. For ease of use, is available in the form of mobile app as well. So it's available on both Android as well as iOS, and also available in Umang app. Suppose if you want to download the app from the for using Android phone, suppose if you want to download it Android phone, then what you need to do is go to Play Store and then search for National Digital Library of India. You have to look for three things: the logo, which is looks like network issue. Is my presentation visible to all of you? Am I audible now? No, actually my in between that new network also failed, so I connected through a new network. So what I will do is webinars, I will turn on my video so that you will be able to have a better webinar experience. Is my audio better now? So I will move ahead. So we have a mobile app for both the Android as well as iOS. So you have to do, what you have to do is go to Play Store and then search for National Digital Library. Okay. Most likely it will be the first app. So you can see this logo and then app name and the publisher name. All the three should be National Digital Library of India. Then you can enter. Similarly, if you are using an iPhone, go to iStore and search for National Digital Library of India. Type the entire word, don't put NDLI, then you may not able to find the app. Okay, type the entire National Digital Library of India. Then you have to look for this logo, app name, and the publisher. All the three should be National Digital Library of India, then you can install it. So now I will show you how to use the NDLI Android app. So once you install the app, just click on open this app. Once you open, this is of the first screen of this this one. This is of the home screen of NDLI mobile app looks like. So it will have a subject domain, learning resource type, and the in mobile app. Suppose if you want to search, then what you need to do is click on this search icon. So this is the search icon in the mobile app. Whereas in the desktop application, it is available at center. Right? Hope you remember. Here, if you want to see the search box, you just click on this
such icon. The expert topic called Uttar Pradesh. Okay. So it fetched me 41,507. If you want filter, in the location, you had the filter option available on the right hand side. Mobile app, it is available on the bottom right corner. This orange color icon, this is the filter option. So it's, if you click on this, then on the third screen, you can see the various filter options available. So here it, there is a content access restriction. So 10 filter options, all 10 filter options will display here. So you just have to, you can actually scroll beyond this and see various remaining filter options. Now, so now let's look at what is the difference between Google and NDL and how is it different with the help of an example. Imagine there is a girl called Pop. Sorry, audience, it's an extremely difficult network issue here. I changed out to 3 networks and all the 3 are almost the same. So, I don't complain. So, kindly bear with me. So I turned off my video, but still, it's a network issue here, so I'm not able to help you here.
Now is my
just try the new net. Just give me a moment.
Okay, so is it better? Okay, sure. So I will shut the presentation again. Okay, so we were looking at the difference between Google and NDLA with the help of an example. So imagine called Payal, who is studying in class 8 and in Hindi medium. Okay. And similarly, there is a guy called Shamik, and he wants to pursue his PhD. And both of their topic of search is magnetism. So first they went and they searched for a topic called magnetism, and they got 1.89 crore results. And then they came to NDLA and they searched for the same topic called magnetism, and they got 11.16 lakh resources. Now, What Payal did is she applied two filters. First is educational level. She chose between 5th to 8th standard. And the second, she chose the languages Hindi. She got 8 results. Imagine where is 8 and where is 1.89 crore. And what Shamik did was, he wanted only career and technical papers and he got 290 results. Now let's see from this example how Google and NDLI are different. So before I get into this, I wanted to make sure NDLI is not a competitor to Google. Or Google is a brilliant tool. It works brilliantly. We don't have any issue with Google's functionality. It's a brilliant tool that the human hand has got. But let's understand how Google functions. The moment you put a search term, say for example, you put a search term called magnetism, what Google does is, it goes around the entire World Wide Web, and wherever this magnetism is there, this topic is there, it will pull the results. In this process, what Google can't do is whether the content is coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether it is a real information or a fake information, whether it is an educational content or a non-educational content, whether it is relevant for Shamik or Payal or Vignesh, it can't do. So it treats everything as equal and it pulls the results and displays it in front of you. On the other hand, what NDLI does is, we primarily work through the content contributors. They are our partners. And all our partners are primarily into educational research and publishing. They are into only the educational domain. So all our content are curated educational contents only. So that's the first major difference. And the second major difference is, you can actually narrow down the results using the various filter options. So I told you about 10 or 11 filter options that are available at NDLI. And whereas in Google also, you have this advanced filter option, but that is very generic in nature. And our filter options, all of them are very specific to educational domain. And you can also modify search based on the content type. And also the Government of India has procured national licensing for NDLI users. So these are some of the major differences between Google and NDLI. Now, I'm going to talk about a new initiative that the Government of India has been doing, which is called NDLI Club. So the objective of NDLI Club is two. The first and foremost is to promote the culture of reading. So that's the first most important objective of NDLI Club. And the second objective is to take forward the NDLI knowledge resource to every Indian citizen. So these are the two objectives. So now let's see how do we planning to achieve this objective. So first thing is, you need to apply for identify the NDLI club members. So the members could be at least one student from each class and one faculty member from each department, with the librarian or a faculty member or an NSS coordinator as the ex officio secretary, and principal or head of the institution as the ex officio chairman of the club. And once the club is formed, then you need to apply for the registration. So we have a URL. I will show you how the form looks like. So this is a temporary arrangement which we've done in a group form. So you see the basic information of your institution has to be filled, and you have to attach the list of NDLI club members and the tentative date of starting the NDLI club in your institution. Once you submit, this form will come to us and we will do a back-end verification of your institution. If it matches our database, then we issue a certificate registration. And this is how the certificate of registration looks like. So this certificate of registration is valid 1 year. Within that 1 year, you need to do two important steps. One is register. First step is register all the students and faculty members within 30 days of receipt. So I will show you how to do this registration part. And the second one is, you need to conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities within this 1 year. So these are the two things that are expected from you. So now I'm going to show you how to do registration. So for doing registration, you have two options. You can go for an individual registration wherein the students or faculty members directly register at NDLI and they start using it, or they go for a bulk registration model. For higher educational institutions especially, the Government of India has been, like you may already know about UGC NAC, AICTE, NBA, when they come for accreditation or renewal or verification, that time they ask you for digital learning resources or digital resources that you or your library subscribe to. There, suppose if you mention NDLI, then they will ask you to produce the certificate from NDLI and also show the number of students or faculty members registered and how many of them have activated their account. In that situation, if they have registered under bulk registration, then only you will be able to show them the number. Otherwise, if they have registered under individual, you may not be able to produce the number of registered and activated numbers. So better for higher education institution, at least if I go for bulk registration. So now I will show you how to do bulk registration. For doing bulk registration, what you can do is, so currently I'm conducting an awareness session for you. Similarly, you conduct an awareness session for your students and faculty members. First target should be the faculty members and then go for the students. Get three details. Their email ID, preferably the personal email ID, their first name and last name. Get this details in an Excel sheet and send it to us. Okay, so you have to send it to this email ID, which is ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in, with a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in or vigneshjaini@gmail.com. Once you send it to us, we will do a bulk automated registration. Within 48 hours, all the registered participants will get a verification email. They just have to click on the URL. By default, their registered email ID is the username, and we will give a temporary password. Just enter it and then they can reset their password. So once they register, they can use it lifelong for free. Now I'm going to show you how to do individual registration. Suppose if your friends or relatives or your family members, they want to use NDLI, they can do it by individuals also. So for doing individual registration, so go to the home page. On the top right corner, you will see this login button. Just click there, then this pop-up window will appear. So here, suppose if you want to register, just click on this register. Once you click on register, this registration form will open. As I mentioned earlier, four details are mandatory. That is your full name, your email ID, password, and confirm password. These four details are mandatory. Rest of the details, date of birth, gender, state, city, educational role, language, institute name, and then you need to enter the CAPTCHA, choose the terms and condition, and then click sign up. Once you click sign up, you will get a verification email. Just activate the URL and then you are all set to use NDL. So now the various activities that you can conduct at NDL, under the NDLI club. So you, these are some of the indicative list of activities. Say for example, a lecture series or a quiz competition, storytelling session, go fish session, film screening, drawing competition, role play, writing competition, maker space, debate. So these are some of the activities that you can conduct. Apart from this, you can also come up with any new reading related activities or any inter-college activities on competitions as well. So objective is to bring back the children to read and actively engage in the activities. And these are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLA. We have closer to 100 active NDLA clubs in the country, and they have collectively conducted over 400 activities in the last 1 year. And we have also designed an incentive mechanism. And soon the government of India will come up with a circular for schools and colleges for starting NDLA club. And also they will incentive, financial incentive for starting an NDLA club in your own institution. So that is underway. That's it from my end. So if you have any questions, I'm happy to answer these questions from you. Thank you so much for your kind patience. Okay, so there's a question from Mr. Krishna Prashad. How to contribute the contents at NDLI? So for contributing content, first you should be an institution. So we can do an institutional content contribution only at this point in time. So you send an email to us. I will connect you with my technical team, which looks after the content partnership, and they will help you with content migration, and they will create an IDR, and then you have to put the data in the metadata format which we follow. Then you can pull the content. Our participation certificate, I will tell you, Ms. Simran. So one by one, please, questions only. So Ms. Simran Surana, how will check out our participation certificate? So now this option is available for people who have already submitted the feedback form. You can download the certificate by entering your mobile number. Suppose if you have already submitted the feedback, you will be able to download the certificate again. Okay. So this is a lifetime free content, as I mentioned, 3.5 crore contents are full text resources, which you can download it without having to spend a single penny to anybody. Okay. So this feedback form, the feedback form is available. I will share the, just give me a moment. I will give you the, so you have to wait till 7 o'clock for submitting the feedback form. Just give me a minute. I will tell you if the registration feedback form is up. Okay, so the feedback form is not yet up. So I will, you have to bear with me for next few minutes before I give you the share the feedback form with you. And if there is any questions, I would be happy to respond. Yes, so what you can do is, the institutional registration is closed for the last couple of years. Okay, so you have to wait for, so you have to send a bulk registration request, then you will be able to see the thing. Are there English children fiction available? Yes, but you have to check, because I've searched a lot. I might have searched around 1,500 topics in the last couple of years. Not even one single incident I came across without a result. So we have results for everything, but you need to narrow down depending on your request, and then you can let me know. So all the students, as I mentioned, KG to PG, everyone is eligible for Ms. Tanvinder Kaur. Everybody is eligible for using NDLI. There is no age limit. How to attract users to NDLI? So very good question. So in one of the institutions, what they have done is they have made NDLI as part of their curriculum. So what they have done brilliantly is every month they give an assignment or a homework or something like that. The faculty member give a topic primarily from NDLI, and they request the students to take the resources from NDLI. So in that process, what happens is NDLI becomes a part of the curriculum. So once you start using it as part of your curriculum, then it becomes a, so every month at least we get 10,000, 20,000 hits only from that one particular institution. So if you want to get NDLI, first show this amount of resources that are NDLI at free of cost. Need to get the faculty members reach out to the students. So that's the best way of doing it. So I will give you my contact number, but my humble request to all of you is kindly tell me who you are in the, so don't call me after 6, because I have a family responsibility as well. So between 10 to 6, if it's very urgent, call me. Otherwise, you can send me a message on WhatsApp. Okay. And when you send a message, kindly tell me who you are, when we got in touch, and what the support you require. Then you can do it. So it's a completely free of cost resource. We don't charge a single penny from any institute. As of now, it's completely free. So you can do it. So I have given my mobile number, which is 998. So any support, kindly send me a message between 10 to 6. Okay. Tell again about bulk registration. So bulk registration, what you need to do is next capture the personal email ID, their first name and last name. Only 3 details you need to capture of each student and faculty member, and then need to send to email so you can copy it, then I will get it and click. And this recording will be available at Pain Panic Foundation's YouTube channel. So from there you can check the contact number and this email ID and the format in which you have to send it. Yes, I can share the presentation. I will check with Balakopalji if it can be uploaded on a website. Otherwise, I will find out a mechanism through which I can send you the presentation. Or you can send me an email. I will be able to get it through to you. So just give me a moment. I will share the feedback from URL. It's not yet active. One more minute before this gets activated. Sorry, I will give the number again. It's 9999654458. I hope it's 10 digit now. Yes, it's a 10 digit now. It's 9999654458. Any other questions? Okay, so the feedback form URL is on now. I will just share the feedback form URL with you. And this will be live for 1 hour. So I've just re-entered the feedback form URL in the chat window. Kindly don't post any message for next few minutes so that everybody can click on the feedback form URL and submit the feedback. Yes, I will try my level best to get this across, get this PPT across to you. So kindly bear with me. Alternatively, this will be available on our website also, on our project website also. So I will see if I can get it across to you, right? So thank you so much once again, all of you. So if you have any questions or if you need any support, kindly send me an email. I will put my email ID as well, vigneshjnu@gmail.com and vignesh@ndl.gov.in. And my mobile number is 9999654458. I've just entered it in the chat window and I have pasted the feedback form URL. Now everybody has got. So I will give you 1 hour to submit the feedback form. After that, this will be closed. Let me just check. It is opening. The feedback form is opening. So go to a place where there is good internet connection. Then you will be able to fill this feedback form. So how many of you have got the feedback form URL? How many of you can see the feedback form URL or the feedback form? I can already see a lot of people started downloading the certificate as well. So of course, if it says invalid user, it means you have not registered. So in that case, what you need to do is, I'll show you and I will send you another URL. You must have first registered for this webinar, then only you will be able to fill the feedback form. So here is the URL for the registration. After filling the feedback form, let me just check if it's still the issue, then I will get it fixed. So kindly wait for a few more minutes. Okay, I think it seems to be some technical error. So I will get the technical, I will pass on this message to the technical team and they will be able to fix it in next half an hour or so. So you can try it after 30 minutes. So kindly wait. So this I will ask, request the technical team to open this till tonight, till 12 o'clock. So I will get it, ask the technical team to fix it in next 30 minutes, and then you will be able to do it. So I'm in the meanwhile, I will just give you the URL for feedback form. Okay. Just bear with me till next half an hour. Okay. By I think 8 o'clock, it will be up and running. So kindly bear with me. Thank you. So I'm going to end this webinar now, and I will get this error fixed in next 30 minutes, and then I will get back to you. Thank you. No, you don't have to join again. It's the same URL. It's going to be the same URL through which you have to submit the, otherwise I will get it sent to you on your email ID. That is also possible. I will get it sent to you, your email ID, the registered participant's email ID of this webinar. I will get the feedback form URL sent to your email ID. Okay. Thank you. So I'm going to end this webinar. Once again, I thank you for this participating in this webinar.